Well, my grandkids. That's my favorite stop. Right now, my oldest daughter has all the grandkids, and so it's just one stop. And they're hilarious. They're 9, 6, and almost 3. And if I hear the theme to Frozen one more time, I think I'm going to scream. But they, the two little girls love that movie, and my oldest grandson plays baseball and basketball, so we go to a lot of games. So those are my favorite stops.
Love to hit barbecue when I'm in town, and I fly home every week. I'm only in D.C. during the week. I come home every weekend, and when I come home, love to hit barbecue, love to hit Oklahoma Joe's. You know, you can kind of spread it around, Gates and Jack Stack. Those are top things. But I'll tell you, probably the number one thing I like to do when I come home is play with my 10-month-old daughter. I've got a little girl, and being able to just come home and after being gone for 3 or 4 days and spend time just sitting with her in the living room and seeing how fast she's growing and crawling around on the floor. And that's what I look forward to each week when I have a chance to come home. I'd say Kansas City barbecue. It's one of the things I brag about wherever I go. When I'm in Washington, D.C., I get in debates with the guys from North Carolina and Texas who think they have barbecue there, but clearly Kansas City is the best barbecue in the country, and for that matter, the universe. And so we're pretty proud of it here, and I love to come home and get some Kansas City barbecue. Oklahoma Joe's, one of my favorites, Jack Stack, Gates, all good places. And we've got some other new places popping up. I just ate at a great place today, a new place in Wyandotte County. I'm real proud of our Kansas City heritage, and certainly our barbecue is a great ambassador to the rest of the country.
Oh my gosh. I love Italian food. I love anywhere where I don't have to cook, and it has a nice wine selection. So I love the Yard House up at the Legends. I eat there fairly often. A lot of times we go out as a family, so it's wherever we can fit, 13 to 15 people. I like Paolo and Bill's in Shawnee, so. I'm actually, as unusual as this path has been, I'm actually doing what I always wanted to do as a kid. I've just been on a very interesting life's journey to get here. I was always interested in government in high school, but I didn't run for student council president. I was like the homeroom representative or whatever. And I quit college the first time to get married, and then I always knew I'd go back. And then I always knew I'd go back in political science, but I didn't think necessarily that I would ever run for office. And so things have just kind of happened that I've decided to do this, and I've won some, I've lost some, but I'm really doing something I absolutely love to do. My husband's health issues have, I took a lot of time where I had to be more at home to raise the kids, because I realized early in our marriage that because of his health issues, I could be left alone with three little girls to raise by myself. So I knew I had to go back to college and to get that degree in case that happened. And so there have been times where we've had to put things on hold to deal with family life situations. But yet, it comes back, and now the girls are grown and married, I'm able to do this.
I kind of always wanted to be a farmer. I grew up on a farm. It was a grain and livestock farm. We had wheat and corn and soybeans, and we had livestock and cattle and hogs and sheep and chickens. And I always kind of growing up, I thought it'd be neat to be a farmer. My dad was a farmer. My grandpa was a farmer. I grew up on the same farm that they farmed on. So I'm multiple generation. And so anytime I can even get back to the farm that we still farm on, it's great. It's a peace for me. It's a peaceful place to be. And I really feel like when I think about America, I think about what makes us such a strong country, I think a lot of those roots come from our agrarian background, our agrarian foundation, and the idea that you work off the land and you build you know, you build your life out of the country. And so we carved a life out of that prairie here in Kansas, and it's produced some amazing things. And so it was growing up, that's kind of what I always aspired to be. But eventually the passion of law kind of came across, and I got involved in a lot of things in high school and college that made me really interested in the law. I became a lawyer, and then the lawmaking process, and that's continued to be a passion. But there's always a sweet spot in my heart for farm country. I love Kansas. You know, I want to continue to represent Kansans because I believe that our values, what we stand for here, it's not what's happening in Washington, D.C. I think if we could bottle up what we're doing here in Kansas and share it with the rest of the country, we'd have a much stronger country. And so I'm so proud of Kansas and what we do here, and it's four corners. You know, I think I have the best district in America, and I think we have some great universities, you know, with University of Kansas, K-State, and the other Regents universities, wonderful schools in my community, you know, great place to raise a family. And so I don't think there's any better place in the world than right here in the Kansas City area and across the state of Kansas. And so I go to Washington each week with a source of pride, a sense of pride and excitement about who I represent, what we stand for, and what we're trying to do. This country's headed in the wrong direction. It has been for some time, and everybody knows it. And to solve these problems, we're going to need leaders who can listen to one another, who can study problems and find solutions, and work together to get things done. That's what I've done over the past few years in Washington, D.C. I'm still learning something new every day. I get excited about trying to solve many of these issues, and I look forward to continuing my service on behalf of the great people of the 3rd District of Kansas.
Because I think it's time to reset Washington, D.C.'s priorities. I think it's time that we need someone who will represent middle class and working families, or families who want to be working class families and can't find a job. People who just, you know, have bad breaks happen through no fault of their own. They just sometimes need to have, you know, a little help or an opportunity. I'm not out there to be anything more than I am, but a hardworking person that wants to try and make a difference. And I think the 3rd District deserves a better representation than what they've had the last 4 years.